How's it going, guys? I got a new deck. It's from the giveaway, giveaway contest thing. The thing that I was doing where I asked for creative decks. This is one of them, and called Electric Slide because you basically just use Ampharos and its ability. What is it? Electromagnetic Wall. When it's in the active spot, if anything attaches an energy from the hand, it takes 3 damage. Combine that with Frozen City, it'll take 5 damage as long as Ampharos is in the active spot. Which is why Keldeo is in here along with Lugia. Keldeo is in here just purely as a pivot. It's not meant to attack, but I put blends in here in case I run into a very dire situation where I need to. And I put this battle first because the nerve of this person for running Shaymin Cefagrigus on me. Some nerve, man. That is some serious nerve. But unfortunately, it gets the drop on me with one grass energy before I'm able to actually do anything here. Puts a Yamask on the bench, and that's how I immediately know what the fuck is up. So, if you're keeping track of what's going on in my hand, I do have a rare candy, and Flaffy is just kind of there just because, just in case I can't rare candy. But since I can, I might as well get rid of it, and I'll just go for the Ampharos right now. The thing is Shaymin is really the only one that needs energy. So I'm just going to go ahead and N out. It's my only supporter. Colress really wasn't going to get me a lot there. But I decide to PCOM, get myself a Lugia. And the reason Ampharos is in here is because as soon as something attaches energy, if Ampharos is in the active spot, it loses 50 hit points if it's not a plasma Pokemon, and if Virbank, or no, Frozen City is in play. Unfortunately, Frozen City is not in play, and there is no more attaching that needs to happen. So we already know what's going to happen right here. We see one Yamask on the bench. It happened on the exact last video I uploaded. A Cefagrigus is going to come along, go for 6 feet under, put 3 damage counters on something, and then Shaymin's just gonna go for the revenge blast for 60. So I don't really feel the need to talk about what's going on in this particular video entirely, just because I just got back from Battle Roads today and I kind of wanted to talk with you guys about it. In case you're not familiar with what Battle Roads is, it's kind of like, I don't know, I guess it's a friendly Swiss tournament that counts for points, I guess is the best way to put it. And you just kind of go in with a deck, you play some other people, you see more or less what the meta is looking like at the moment. And I figured that Landorus Cobalion Garbodor would be a cool thing to bring. I'd been reading up on it and it looked like it was a pretty good deck. What am I doing right here? I'll jump back to that in a bit because it's actually my turn, so I want to explain what I'm doing. I think I opt to Skyla for a supporter. I think. Oh no, I'm getting a Floatstone. Getting a Floatstone for some reason. Just to prep, so that way I can get the pivot into Lugia. Because it's going to take 2 Plasma Gales to take out the Shaymin. Because I don't run Tool Scrappers. And the Shaymin is just annoying. But fortunately, he ends me right here. And this was really convenient. But we get a Tool Scrapper right here. Takes it off. Anyways, we can basically see what's going on the screen. So, I went 3-2. One of that deck in particular is supposed to be good against TDK, which is Thunderous Deoxys Kyurem, and it did all right, but it was actually one of the ones I lost to because the guy Junipered away his entire deck just to get to a Scramble Switch that he had laying in there. It was like, holy shit, are you serious? And that's how I ended up losing. It was down to my last 2 prizes, and I had a full HP Landorus, and he just took it out clean, one shot, 180 damage from a tornado. So I was like, fucking kidding me? So that was that loss. The next one was from an actually well-played Darkrai matchup, so there wasn't really a lot I could do about that. But it's worth mentioning that if I beat the guy that was playing Darkrai, I would have taken second. I didn't really notice my ranking because I just kind of walked off after that. After I noticed I wasn't a top 4, I was like, ah, fuck it, whatever, I'll just leave. But it was a lot of fun. I actually had a lot of fun with that deck. It was mildly consistent. I figured, hey, you know what? I could run it. So, in that last turn, all I really did was just got rid of some stuff, Junipered, and then prep myself for a Plasma Gale. It preps a Shaymin for a knockout just so that way, I'll take 3 prizes thanks to Overflow, which is absolutely fantastic. And it puts him in a spot where he needs to get another Shaymin out very soon. That laser was really kind of pointless just because my Shaymin does still have the Floatstone, sitting on the bench and everything. So he goes for a Revenge Blast. It turns out I top deck another Plasma Energy. If I didn't, I just would have Skyled for the Colress Machine and just done that instead. But I'm just gonna go ahead and Plasma Gale right here. I don't really need to throw away anything in my hand, nor do I really need to use anything, so I might as well hang on to it. But because Shaymin is an EX, I get a whopping 3 prizes off of that. That was beautiful. And just because he played Skyler right there, that basically means he lost the game because Shaymin cannot just come from 0 to 2 energy whatsoever unless you run like Team Plasma Badge and Chorus Machine, which is absolutely silly. You have no reason to do that. But it's at this point that I can just Chorus Machine and just put another Plasma Energy on Lugia and then just catch her in the Shaymin. I could have taken out the Yawn Mask, but I just wanted style points. And he scoops before I can even do it. So, moral of the story, don't run a deck that I just uploaded. It's annoying. Okay. Next game with Electric Slide. What else was there to talk about at Battle Roads? Not really much else. There was a Gothitelle Celigor deck. There was like 3 people running that, and it scared the shit out of me. Oh, Jesus, it was terrifying. Okay, I don't know why the second video is lagging a lot. It really doesn't need to be. Can I turn down the quality a little bit? That would be fantastic. There we go. I think that's a little better. So, I guess I just decided to put down Shaymin right now. And this hand really doesn't look too hot. I hate getting Colress in the opening spot. And honestly, I'm not a big fan of the supporter structure in this deck. I think it has one or two too many Colresses. So the one thing I'm wanting to do right now is I want to catch up to Sableye, because that means that he will have to switch. He will have to drop an energy on Sableye or have a switch in order to go to Emolga and have a... and, you know, be able to call for family. But I'm going to go for first turn computer search. I guess I'm getting an N off of that. I'm realizing that it kind of helps him. Why the fuck is this so laggy? Cut that out. Okay, sorry, I fixed that. That's a lot better. What do we have going on? So I catch her in the Sableye as planned. And I believe I'm just going to go ahead and N after that computer search. Just to hopefully come into something better. Spoilers, I really don't, but I get a Lugia and a DCE. I don't think this deck is really one to run hammers in the first place. I'm going to hold off on Ultra Balling for now, just in case I actually might need any of those supporters. I'm really not 100% yet. But because this Sableye's in the active spot, he's going to have to just get his stuff some other way. I actually zoom in on the cards a little bit just to show you what they do, in case you're kind of new to the channel and you don't really know what's going on with these cards slash are unfamiliar to the TCG completely. Maybe I'll do some kind of tutorial thing. I keep telling myself that, but honestly, like, you watch the videos and you kind of get it after a while. Not to sound kind of mean, but that's honestly how I caught on after a while. It's pretty straightforward. So I'm going to Chorus Machine to get a Plasma Energy out of the deck, and then I decide to just Ultra Ball away those two whatchamacallits, and I believe I'm getting another Mareep, just because I can just Juniper and then hopefully come into a Rare Candy and an Ampharos. Turns out I get a Flaffy, and I have an Ampharos in my hand, which is, this is alright. Now, this is a really good matchup for a lot of reasons. As soon as I get the Ampharos in the active spot, it means that the instant he drops an energy on a Beedrill, it will not be at full HP, and it completely ruins the structure of the deck. So he needs to get Ampharos out of the active spot. And if I put down a Frozen City and he doesn't have a Veerbank, that's basically it, because Beedrill is not a Team Plasma Pokemon. It'll take damage from that as well. So the sooner I can get my Frozen City before his Beedrill, or my Ampharos before his Beedrill, the better, because that's basically how it works. And then right off the bat, the threat has been identified. I'm talking about the little purple shitbag of trash right there. He will shut off my Plasma Gale, my Rushin, and my Electromagnetic Wall. So the threat has been identified, and you know what I'm going to do about it? First off, I'm going to evolve that, which has nothing to do with that whatsoever. It kind of works for the Beedrill, though. And I think I'm going to Ultra Ball. What am I getting? I'm getting my Ultra Ball and my Skyla, I kind of want to say. Tossing those to get myself one more Pokemon, just to be able to get one more extra card off of Colress. I decide, what the hell, we'll get another Mareep. And I believe I'm going to catcher up the Trubbish and go for a Colress and hopefully get one energy for my Lugia to go in and do that. Turns out I don't get it, but I do get another Ampharos just so I have a nice little bit of security there. I can also drop another Mareep if I really want to, but I'm praying he doesn't run Colress in this deck. And I believe I'm just going to rush in and retreat to my fresh Ampharos for absolutely no reason whatsoever. Yeah, I really didn't have much of a reason to do that. But if I hit another Colress, at least I'll be able to Colress for 9, unless something gets freaking dropped right now. The fact that I have an Ampharos here is just really bad news for him until he gets a Garbodor up. Because once that ability is shut off, then he can start putting stuff down. But once I get a Frozen City out, he has to have a Veerbank to get rid of that. So he has counters, but they're very limited, and it's not really... his deck is not really intended to run into Ampharos, period. This is just one of those once in a blue moon thing where the poke on the other side of the field literally will shit on your entire day. Kind of like seeing a Landorus T in the video game when you have a Scarf Terrakion out. Very common thing to happen. Except for this. This is just like, what the shit are you doing, Eric? Okay. He's going to go ahead and level ball for a Kakuna. That's all right. And then he passes, which is wonderful. So I believe I'm going to Ultra Ball away a Lugia and a Max Potion, just because I don't really feel the need to have more than one Lugia right now. And I do have another Lugia in my deck anyways, and I don't have the bench space for another one, so I might as well toss it, get another Ampharos out of it, and then my last card is a Juniper, so I get a fresh 7 off of that. Wonderful. Don't get an energy, but I get the way to get an energy. So I finally get 4 energy on that Lugia. Gonna go ahead and Rush Treat into my Lugia and then get rid of that Veerbank, put down a Frozen City, and now the thing is ruined. So I'm looking to see what else I can get, and I can't really get anything, so I just decided to leave it in there. And I'm gonna go ahead and Plasma Gale for 120, getting rid of the Trubbish, and thanks to the overflow ability, that will get me a second prize. It will get me an additional prize, I should say that. If I knock out an EX, that's 3 prizes, and you guys are actually going to see that in the, I think, the next 2 games, and you guys already saw that in the previous game too. I think in every single one of these games, except for this one, I straight up just drop an EX, and that's what's great about Lugia, because it takes a number of knockouts on big basics you have to take from 3 to 2. The problem is Lugia has a pretty high attack cost. And that's a little unfortunate, but if you can get, like, the best, if you can get good support for it, then it's really not that bad. I actually saw a decent amount of them today. I saw that in Snorlax. I actually didn't have a matchup on it. What the shit? Can you just, no. Okay. We got someone in Skype group talking to me. What's happening? So he's Ultra Balling for another Trubbish. I will not have this at all. I need to get knockouts before that thing comes along. And it turns out he is going to go ahead and put down a Floatstone and evolve into a Beedrill. But I'm really thinking that last one's not a supporter, so I'm really 100% okay with this. He's kind of in a bad spot where all he can really do is junk hunt. And I top deck a Colress. How freaking beautiful was that? So I get the Colress for a sexy 9. Get to go ahead and catcher in the Trubbish, and then Plasma Gale that thing, drop it for another 120 as well. So there's 2 more prizes. It just cuts the length of the game just so much. That's why I had to put a lot of these videos together. Games where Lugia does good are short for a damn good reason. So he lasers right here. I kind of want to say this is just really pointlessly lasering, just because, you know, I can just Rush Treat. Now, this is really unfortunate right here that I actually ended up top decking a Plasma Machine, or not Plasma Machine, Plasma Energy, because that's all I needed to attack. I already have a DCE and a blend, and I just have to attack one more thing, and that's it. And then, because he got a Tails on the laser, I can just do it now. I don't really need to think about it. So he goes for another laser from the Junk Hunt, and I believe he's going to get something else. So that and a Gold Potion. And I just, yeah, there's that. I honestly don't know what I would have done besides that. I probably would have end myself into a different hand and basically just prayed for that. And it turns out I had a plasma machine. God damn it, that's what the combo is called. It's really not. I just keep mixing up those two. Okay, as you can see, I get a handful of items and special energies. That's nice. It's basically what the format looks like right now. Get to shuffle out into a new hand. Turns out I get a Mareep. I think Mareep actually sees a little bit of play in this one. Honestly, like, this deck plays fine without it, but it plays great with Frozen City, and I was just like, you know what, I really, really, really want to see Ampharos get some use, so I figured I'd give it a shot, and I think it does good in this one and the next one, if I'm not mistaken. So right here, what I could do is I could Skyla for an Ultra Ball, but I'm trying to remember what I discard in order to get something out into play. Or am I just getting, no, I'm not getting a Frozen City. I wait for them to put down the Veerbank and then I play the Frozen City, because if it's 2-2 stadiums, the person that puts down their stadium first will ultimately end up losing the stadium war if you have the same number, just because they kind of override themselves that way. But I think I ultimately decide to get an Ultra Ball, and I'm not really feeling too comfortable with what I'll have to end up discarding for this. But I think, what am I getting? I think I'm going to discard the blend and the Colress ultimately. Or what am I doing? Am I doing that? I think I'm doing that. God, that was a thinker. That was a real thinker for me. But I want to get the Lugia down, and I also want to get the DCE on it, which is why I opted to do that. And I'm going to end my turn, because you know why? Because that freaking Marip will, you know, turn into an Forest next turn just because of my hand. So, Sableye is a thing out there, not doing anything. That's all he's got going on. I'm hoping, I was really hoping I could just end into a, like, two Colrus machines, and just beautiful, beautiful. That would have been fantastic. That is a quick, aggressive Lugia that happens maybe, like, one every 10 games for me. But it's not bad. I actually really love it when that happens. What do we have going on right now? So, he town maps, which is not something you really see in Darkrai too often. Nor do you really see Sharon too much. So, I'm thinking this is a guy that wanted to build Darkrai, but just didn't really have everything together, or he's just trying some really off the wall kind of things, you know. Honestly, I just really want to get this Ampharos up before the Darkrai gets any energy on it, because all Ampharos needs is two electromagnetic wall activations, and then Darkrai goes down from 180 to 120, setting it up perfectly for a Lugia KO. Darkrai's really just stopped playing Eviolites. You guys remember when that was a thing? Those of you guys, that was a thing for maybe like a month or two, and now they just all run Dark Claws. So I'm gonna go ahead and Rare Candy that one. And I believe I'm going to N out. I know it helps him, but I kind of need a little bit of help right now at the moment, too. So I decide to put down a Marip, and I believe I'm putting down a blend on the Ampharos because I'm actually kind of prepping for it to attack. Its attack is not too shabby, and if I really need to, I can just slap down a blend and a DCE, and it's a 70 to the active and 20 to a benched Pokemon. So it's kind of like a B-plus version of Nightspear. And it's got a cool ability. Ampharos is a cool poke. It just doesn't really have a good deck structure going on for it. I don't know. It's not bad. Like, I zoomed in on it for a pretty generous amount right there. It's pretty cool, if you ask me. Like I said, I hadn't really found the use for it till now. I was thinking maybe that and Rocky Helmets, but I just couldn't find the room for Rocky Helmets in this deck. I like Max Potions on there just to keep the Ampharos alive longer. I almost got to a point earlier when I was playing this where I thought about using a Max Potion on a Lugia. So he just kind of hammered away, like, almost everything except for a blend. And then I got to, like, 140 damage. I was like, I think it's kind of worth it right now. But that's not what happened. So, I guess I'm dropping that DCE. Okay. I think I'm ending. Just straight ending. So, what do I have here? Not really a lot much else. I keep drawing into supporters. So, that's either A, me having too many supporters, or B, just what the shit is going on. I really couldn't tell you. So I set that up right there, just because that'll make him have 130 HP, and if he wants to be able to attack, he has to drop an energy from hand, which puts an extra 30 on him, which leaves him at 100 HP, which means that Lugia, once it gets a Colrus machine and an energy, will be set, will be perfect, and there's not a damn thing you can do about it. So I'm gonna eat a Night Spear right here that is going to knock me out. And I am ultimately trying to think about what I want to promote. Do I feel lucky enough at this point? I actually really don't feel lucky enough at all. I decide, you know what, I'm just going to have to go for the Marip because I don't have a supporter that will get me a lot of cards right now. So I can, however, get rid of his Verbank. So I believe I'm going to Ultra Ball away a Colrus and a... Ugh, that was rough. Why did I do that? I think I'm getting another Marip just because that active one's... Oh, I'm getting Keldeo. Okay, never mind. So I'll do that. Oh, that's right. So I put down all that shit just to be able to do that. And then I come into, like, the most beautiful hand ever afterwards. Turns out that I just sat down that Marip, so I can't really evolve it. I have to end my turn right here, and I have to let the active Marip die so I can promote Lugia and then do that shit I wanted to next turn. That kind of should have been a red flag to him, I guess, maybe. I don't know. Catches up my Lugia, and is going to do, like, crazy mad damage to it, but I don't think he has a Verbank, so it's fine. A Night Spear is going to do... Shit, what? 90? Because he doesn't have a Dark Claw attached. So he'll be at 120. If he lasers, I'll be at 130. If he laser banks, he'll be at 150. The fact that he did not get a Tails on that one was mildly important, just because I did not have the means to rush treat because I don't have a Floatstone, nor do I have any supporters in my hand. But it's great right now. I was getting Tails all day with lasers every time I used it, so I've been on the other side of that. And yeah, it kind of sucks, but it's my turn. It's my turn for justice. So I get to evolve a bench Meryt now, so that's kind of cool. I also get to put down a... I think I'm just putting down a blend, and I'm also going to go for a Chorus Machine to put a Plasma Energy just to fulfill Plasma Gale's requirement, and then just drop this motherfucker. Half the game, won already. Turned it from a 5-5 to a 5-2. Look at that shit. And it turns out I draw a Chorus Machine. I hate having Chorus Machines and Plasma Energies in hand. That is so pointless. Oh my god, that's like putting training wheels on a unicycle. Okay, got the Sableye in the active though, and honestly all it really takes is just me attacking that and it's over. So that's all I have to do. You know, it's got less than 120 HP, and I'll just do that. I guess I'll just talk about battle roads while I wait for this to finish. So what was my first battle? What was it? I think it was an eel matchup. I'm pretty sure it was eels. Yeah, I think it was eels. And it was eels and Zekrom, so it was like some really, really early, like, Noble Victories looking stuff. Anyway, I just Gyarados and then just Landorus the shit out of all of it. Second matchup, what was it? I do not remember what round two was. What was round two? And did, or maybe that was round two. Round one was... Fuck, I really can't remember. I don't know, it probably wasn't that important. And then round three was the TDK one. Ended up losing that one just almost by deck out. If that Scramble Switch was prized, that would have been beautiful, and he would have just Junipered for nothing. But I'm pretty sure he looked in his deck already, and he already figured that out. Shit. And then round four? Round four was another loss. That was a Darkrai one. And then round five was a straight-up fucking dunk. I led off with Landorus, and he had Lillipup because he was running that Stoutland shit, which I'll probably end up building on this channel as well. Stoutland gets this. And I just Landorus, and that was it. So I see an opportunity here. Do you guys see this? Do you guys fucking see this? I'm going to take it. So we have a DCE, and we have a Chorus Machine, and we have a Mew EX on the bench that has exactly 120 HP. So if I knock that thing out, I will take three prizes on the first turn. So what I'm aiming to do right there, I Ultra Ball just to thin some stuff out of my deck to increase the amount of odds I have into getting a Chorus Machine. And it turns out I got it. So I go from zero to four energies, and all of a sudden his day is half ruined just because I get rid of the Mew, and bam, would you look at that? I freaking, oh God, that was, I need a minute. I need a minute, and I need a box of tissues, because that was just about that hot. So, we have two Sableyes on the bench as well. Those are going to be my main targets as well. I can also Skyla for a catcher right here. And the fact that he Chorus is just like, okay, no N, that's great. So, Lasers right here. If he got a Heads, I would have Skyla'd for a Floatstone. But he didn't, so yeah. Or I probably would have just Juniper just to get some stuff going on. But he X-Balls for like crazy mad damage. And then it turns out I think I'm getting the Floatstone. Am I? All right. I think I'm going to hold off on what I was thinking about because I realized I cannot get the Floatstone to get rid of the poison and catcher at the same time. That's not a thing that exists. So I bring in Keldeo, and it doesn't look like he has a lot of cards in his hand anyway. So I think right here I have a freaking Plasma Energy in my hand, so I figure I'm just going to toss a Chorus Machine. It's just like that thing I was talking about in the last game. If you have it in your hand, you might as well put it down. And with Juniper next turn, it's going to be either a use it or lose it scenario. So I think I'm Ultra Balling right here, kind of setting up the Ampharos in the background as well. And I think I'm just going to end my turn. So I don't really think Ampharos got a lot of use outside of that third game. But the concept's there, so you guys can kind of see what this deck is about. It just so happens that in three out of four of these games, Lugia pulled the weight by itself, and Ampharos was just riding on its head, egging it on. But goes for a Laser right here. I think he also whiffs it, so a lot of tails on TCGO today, which is absolutely fantastic for me. Because I got a lot of tails, like I said, while going for Lasers myself. There was plenty of important opportunities where I needed my opponent asleep, and I didn't get him. I didn't get him, so I think he just undoes that attachment and decides to drop a, I think he put a Dark on that Sableye, and he does something kind of peculiar in that he retreats. I would have just kept hammering in there, but he's basically presented a prize for me to take right now. So I think I end up going for the Plasma Energy on that. I think I'm just retreating out to this, and then just, am I Junipering? I think I'm Junipering right now. Oh, I'm max potioning off the Keldeo, because, I mean, you might as well use it or lose it, that kind of thing. So, anyway, Frozen City comes out. I also get a... No, I don't. I'm just going to Plasma Gale. Y'all know how that works. Lugia doing the thing, doing the work, doing the business. Look at that. So, got another Sableye out. And I honestly don't think that he has another DCE in hand unless he top-decked one. So, turns out he gets a laser. This is honestly kind of in vain, because I still have Keldeo. Float Stone on the bench. Hello? Okay, I really don't understand why people do that. Like, why will you throw away that many lasers? I mean, I guess it was a use it or lose it kind of thing right there. But I was already poisoned in the first place. You could have just thrown it away. I don't know. Yeah, I guess if he was going to Juniper. Just to get the sleep. Just to say, hey, after two lasers, I got the sleep. But ultimately, it didn't matter. So, look at that. Three Colruses. Gee, look at all this. Look at all these cards I'm going to get off this Colrus. A whopping four. That's amazing. And it turns out he gets rid of my Plasma Energy, but he whiffs the Crushing Hammer. So, that kind of scared me a little bit there in that he's actually running both of those. But he did not get rid of my DCE, which is actually pretty great, because that means I only need two more energy. I have a Chorus Machine in hand, and I have a Blend Energy in hand to make it happen, or just a Chorus Machine and something else. So, I'm going to Rush Treat, I believe, to get rid of the poison. Or, am I doing that? What am I doing? I'm just doing that. Am I not doing the thing? I should be doing the thing. Past like 10 minutes ago, Eric, what are you doing? Are you doing the thing? Yes, you're doing the thing. Wonderful. Okay, so I got another Plasma Energy down on that, and I'm just going to drop a DCE, retreat for free thanks to Floatstone, and get rid of this sumbitch Sableye with a Plasma Gale. So that's Lugia doing a lot of work, and Ampharos basically being the cheerleader, and Keldeo being the float that they are riding on the parade for. So that was four games with Electric Slide. Special thank you to Poliswagger for sending me the deck idea. It's pretty fun. I just haven't really gotten into a situation where Ampharos is just like, oh, you know, fuck you and your energy. I haven't gotten that, like, five Frozen City situation yet. But to be fair, I've only been playing this deck for, like, 2 or 3 days. So maybe you guys will see this more in the future. I'm also kind of getting to the point in the format where after I build shit like Weavile Execute, you know, like Flareon and a couple of other things, I still have TDK built as well. So once I kind of get through those, I'm just going to get to the point where I'm just going to start looping around old decks again, like I kind of had been. So, I mean, if you guys want to see an older deck that I've already played before in the near future, let me know in the comments right now. Otherwise, I'm just going to try to keep getting new decks out to you guys, because I've gotten a lot of cards in the downtime to the point where I can pretty much just pick up any deck I want to and then just make it from scratch. So that was a thing. It's a Sunday upload, which is noteworthy. So hope you guys are enjoying it. Hope you guys are having a nice Sunday as well. And if you did enjoy it, you're welcome to leave a like, rating, comment, and subscribe and do your thing. And I will see you guys on the next one. Goodbye.